So first, Happy New Year to everyone. Last year was an absolutely incredible year. We saw things that happened in the stock market that no one anticipated was going to happen. For instance, the S&P 500. Believe it or not, you know, it rose double digits for the year, but off the bottoms of March, we saw a better than 60 to 65% gain. All right, what's in store for this year? Well, we're going to take a look at that in this video, and I want to do something a little different. I'm going to look at the markets using longer-term charts, and I'm going to look at 12 charts with you in what I call my 2021 sector analysis. So let's get going. Hey everyone, Tom Gentile. Welcome to Tom's Trading Room. Glad to have you here. Another year, and hopefully another year where I can give you some great education by spotting opportunities, taking alternative risks in the market other than simply buying and holding, and of course, planning, executing, and managing your trades. So we're going to do that right now. Now, before I begin though, let me mention this real quick. Number one, we all know that stocks and options have large potential rewards, but they also have large potential risks. The other thing I want to mention is that I am not an investment advisor. All right, so I don't give specific individualized trading advice. That's between you and your broker. So let's get to spotting some opportunities on these 12 charts. Okay, let's first start with the S&P 500. The lows that occurred back at the end of March of 2020 took us down to 220 on SPY. That's what we're looking at right now. We've had a very consistent run, although it was a lot more volatile back at the beginning of, or really the middle of last year, before finally consolidating after Labor Day and then pushing up even higher to recent all-time highs just a few weeks ago. And so what we're looking at here is a long-term chart, and I'm trying to find support points if we were to pull back. Now, we have a new chart here, or a new high, recent new highs in SPY. So the 38% retracement level, this pullback number you see here, is, I believe, a valid number, just below 320 on the S&P. Now, that's quite a bit of a way to go. But remember, today we're looking at long-term charts. We're looking at something that, in this case, is 9 months. All right, 9 months or longer, in my opinion, is a longer-term chart. But you're seeing 38% retracement at just below the 320 level, the 50% retracement sitting right on or right below the 300 level, and the 61% retracement just above 280. That's what we're looking at for long-term buy points on SPY if we do get pullbacks. Let's take a look at sectors. Now, before I get into sectors, what are sectors and how can you find out more about what I call spider sectors? Well, the easiest way to do that is simply go and Google spider sectors, all right? And you're looking at SPDRS, and you can come to the sectorsspdr.com. Again, sectors with an S, pdr.com, sectorspider.com. Go there and click, and this is the actual homepage that you'll see. And there are 11 different S&P index funds that trade throughout the day on what's called NYSE ARCA. You can learn more about those, again, at sectorspiderets.com. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and look at each one of these. Now, how do they line up with the S&P? Well, if you click on the pie, you'll be able to see that, for instance, the energy sector only accounts for 2.32% of the S&P 500, where if you go to XLK, for instance, technology, 27.5% weighting as of the 4th of this year. And so you can go through and you can hit the pie slices on every one of these graphs. And there's so much more to do on this site that I simply don't have time to talk about in this video. But go check it out for yourself. What we're going to do is what you can't do in this particular website. And that is look at not just the charts, because you could look at the charts on this website, but look at what the options are telling us on these different spider selects. So let's go to stock charts once again. And I'm going to move to the first one, and that is XLE. XLE is the Energy Select Spider Sector. And as you can see, back in March, it was trading down here at a low of 24. If you remember, the price of oil back in March and April was really sliding. And that actually, that price sent the energy markets, believe it or not, in this particular sector, actually going higher. We went from 24 to 46.86 before starting to pull back. And we pulled back once again through our retracement lines. Now, what does this chart tell me? This chart only tells me two things. Here's the absolute low over the last year, 23.48. Here's the absolute high over the last year, 46.86. We've gone through the 38.50 and 61% retracement levels on the downside and on the upside. So these three areas here are invalid. The only thing that makes sense in this particular sector is hardline support, 23.48, hardline resistance, 46.86. And to me, as a trader, I don't do anything on either one of these until I get a signal or I get a trend breakout either above the high or below the low. Implied volatility has come down significantly since March of last year and has been hovering down here in the range of around 40. Now, considering that it was at over 100 last year, this looks rather cheap, right? And it is still rather cheap compared to the low bounce that occurred just in the dog days of August. That's XLE. All right, really no trends there. Moving on, XLU. This is the utilities select spider. All right, utility spider had lows back in March, like the stock market, then proceeded to create some higher highs and consolidation all the way from April into September before breaking out, coming up and hitting new highs. We had lows at the far left-hand side of the chart. We had highs near the right-hand side, but look at the pullback. The fact that we had this move up here, this area of 58.42, very significant. That's a significant support point. So is 55.85. 53.27, not so much. I really like the 38 and 50% pullbacks on markets that are trending higher and that have recently been. And I say recent because this happened right before Thanksgiving. Recently been hitting new highs, right? So there's your pullback. I look at the buys long term for XLU. Let's move on to the technology sector, XLK. This is the one. Remember, 27.5% of the S&P is coming right out of this particular sector. XLK, 70 back in March, 130 and change just a few days ago, starting to pull back very slightly, but not much, right? But if we do start to see the big pullbacks, then we're looking at 107. That's the 38% retracement area. We're looking at just about 101 on the 50%. And of course, the 60% takes us down to 93 and change. Again, this is so strong right here that these two areas of pullback represent the best pullback buying opportunities long term when looking at this chart. Now, what is there anything on here that concerns me? Well, last year, just in March last year, we were sitting at around 85. On implied volatility. Basically, option premium is very high. It dropped significantly during the March to June timeframe and really kind of bottomed out down here just below 25. And it hit 25 once, twice, and has been at and below 25. But look what happened just in the new year. We spiked above 30. Is this a calling that the market could be ready to pull back? It very well could be. We've had a really good run this year. And with the uncertainties that are coming up in the marketplace, especially this week with the Georgia runoff, this could signal that there could be a rotation out of tech and into potentially value. We've talked about this on podcasts just last month. So keep an eye on this one. It has led the gains for the most part for the S&P, and it could be the one that leads us into pullback mode. Next, XLB, this is the materials, the building materials select spider fund. Now, building materials have been on a tear too. This is a pure US dollar play. When the US dollar drops and gets cheaper, it's going to make goods more than services. head higher. And we've seen below 40 back on March 23rd, and now sitting above 70, sitting right around the highs were close to 72 here just yesterday, all right, before pulling back. Look at the implied volatilities. 100 back at the end of March. We've come all the way down to 20 and bounced around the 20. But again, we popped up again and we haven't seen 30. You got to go back into December, to beginning of December, before you see 30 on options premium. And again, this one, when you look at this and we're hitting hundreds, and what I mean by hundreds, we're hitting all-time highs. And if the market starts getting shaky, these are the ones that typically go first, right? Because they've been so strong to the upside, they could be the ones that make the biggest pullbacks to the downside. Moving on. XLP, this is the Staples Select Sector, consumer staples. Consumer staples also have recently hit new highs, but not as recent as technology, not as recent as building materials. Check this out, 48 on the low back at the end of March of 2020. The highs actually occurred again before the Thanksgiving holiday, and it's really kind of been sitting here and found some support right around the 66 level. Pullback area, $60.71 is the first area of support on the Fibonacci chart. Then we got 58.41, 56.10. What's been going on with implied vol? All right, option premium was very high, like everything else, dropped down, and it's really been hitting this bottom. Now, what's interesting is that we saw that spike that happened at the beginning of the year, and it's come back down a little bit since then. So, you know, is it telling us that that support, that short-term support, is likely to hold? That's what it tells me as an option trader. But if you're playing the long game and you expect pullbacks, then this is the area to look at as far as buying opportunities. XLP, the Consumer Staples Select. Next, XLY. XLY is the consumer discretionary sector, and consumer discretionary has done very well. Again, like technology, it was low on the far left-hand side, in this case, March 23rd, down here below 90, and just very, very recently has been just above 160, starting to get a little bit of pullback here. And look at the option chart, looks very similar. A big drop after March, and then this bottoming that occurred for generally the rest of the year. Now, it is not above its highs in December, so I would look at that one, and that's also because it's not below its lows of December. So that's the first area that I would look at as far as breach of support. Right from there, we're really looking at about 133. Looks like that area where we hit the 38% level, 125 is the 50% level for longer term support and longer term bullish opportunities. XLI, that's the industrial select spider. Industrials 2, very low on the bottom side, below 50, on the high side, near 90, before rolling over just before Thanksgiving and starting to create this little bit of lower high and lower low. The other thing that's significant here is that the moving averages, the 10 and 30, crossed about a week ago. So this could be an area where maybe we're not bearish, but maybe we shouldn't be bullish either. Maybe this is now a sideline industry to look at. And you can look at the Dow, because the Dow makes up a lot of what's in the industrial sector. And you can see these pullbacks. All right, where are the buying opportunities? Well, as far as Fibonacci is concerned, 38% at 74.05, 50% at 69.23 on a chart that has been pretty much up and to the right for the better part of 2020. XLC, this is the Communication Services Select. Now, I don't have enough data on XLC because I just haven't been collecting the data on this one. But as you can see here, since the end of August, it has been up and to the right. But we do see shorter term. Now, this is a shorter term chart, and we're seeing these buying opportunities just off the November areas where we saw some support here at 64.14 and at 63.11. Right, we're at 66 right now. So to get from 66 to 63.11, that's about a 5% drop in this particular sector here. And this sector again, XLC. XLV is healthcare. All of us have been front and center on healthcare with the pandemic, and healthcare has done extremely well. In fact, it really shot up a lot back in March, April, May, and June. And then it kind of just started to not so much roll over, but it couldn't keep this trajectory up. And in fact, we saw 100 all the way out until the beginning of November before we shot up to new highs, and recently hit new highs just below 115, right? The buy points are at 99, 94, and 89 on 3850, and of course, 61% retracements. That's on the healthcare sector, XLV. XLF is the financials. Financials have actually done really well as of late. Take a look here. You got XLF, trading below 18 back in March of last year. It had a big spike, and then it went into this triangle formation that finally broke as we got into November and has just been slowly moving up ever since. And we're seeing something that was at 18 in March of last year that is trading just below 30. Just a few days ago. Pullbacks take it back to 25 is the 38% pullback. 23.75 would be your 50% pullback. And of course, 22.25 is the 61% pullback. For those of you looking at the long term on financials and you think financials need a break, then these are the areas that look bullish to me, looking at the technicals of XLF. And finally, let's take a look at the most recent one that I've been looking at as of lately, and that's XLRE. This is the real estate spider, and this particular spider select was at 25 in March of 2020 and jumped all the way to 38. And look at this. The high that occurred actually occurred in June. We have not seen the high. Now, this was an intraday high. This was an intraday high too, but the last time we had a high that was a closing high, you got to go back to June of last year. So this to me looks very weak when we look at all of the select spiders in the group. So how do you play these select spider sectors as an option trader? Well, if you're in the long game, then you know I like selling put premium as a way of acquiring stocks, and in this case, select spider sectors at or below their current prices. So that's one way I like to play the long game. Get paid to buy these, maybe even at their Fibonacci points, those 38% and 50% retracement levels. And it's kind of like putting a limit order in ahead of time and getting paid to do so. Doesn't guarantee you're going to get them at those prices, but it does set you up that if they do pull down, and they pull down at or below those prices by the expiration date, that you will indeed get those particular stocks, or in this case, those particular select spider sectors, at a predetermined price. And finally, what about Bitcoin? Bitcoin has been on fire. I know all of you know that if you've been looking at it during the holidays. So on my next video, I'm going to come back to Bitcoin, and we're going to look at my 2021 predictions for that, as well as other cryptocurrencies. So be on the lookout for that one, and I'll see you then. Bye now.